Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Miss Elaine's Book Nook. The first thing I planned to do today was announce the winner from those special six wonderful picture books that we read on the last two episodes. But I don't really have a winner, because guess what? None of you voted! But that's okay. I figured you liked them all so much you just couldn't decide. That happens to me a lot. I'm still going to announce the winner according to second graders here in Bethel Park, because remember, we read these same stories to second graders and they voted during last school year. So here's the winner. It was not Giant Dance Party. And it was not Xander's Panda Party. It wasn't What Floats in a Moat. And it wasn't My Lucky Birthday. It was not Creepy Carrots, although that came in a close second, because that was a really fun one too. But the winner was, are you ready? The winner was The Day the Crayons Quit by Drew Daywalt. And secretly, boys and girls, this was my favorite too. I was hoping that this title would win. Well, today's show, boys and girls, is all about back to school, because it's that time of year. And some of you may be going to school for the very first time. That's super exciting. Maybe you're starting preschool. And I know a lot of boys and girls at home might be a little bit nervous, worried, or scared about preschool because they might be sad about leaving mom and dad. But guess what? Once you get there, it's so much fun. It's super fantastic, and you'll love it. It'll be the best. Some of you might be starting kindergarten, and that's really exciting too. You'll be going to the elementary school with the big kids. And maybe some of our viewers are starting first grade. But whatever grade you're starting, we do wish you the very best. And today's show, as I said, is dedicated to back to school. So we're going to start, boys and girls, with something that we've never done on Miss Elaine's Book Nook before. We're going to start with what's called a draw and tell story. So as I'm telling the story, I'm going to be drawing on my paper. And in the end, it's going to make a picture. And we'll see if you can guess what it is. Okay? So this is a story about a little girl named Bella who liked school and loved recess. That was her very favorite part of the day, because at recess, she and her friends would go outside, walk across the street, right past a rounded rock that always sat there on the grass, and then they'd walk down the hill. Sometimes they'd skip around the baseball field and watch some of their classmates play baseball. But that was only days when they had extra time to spare. Usually, they'd keep running right straight past a big hole in the ground. And they'd keep skipping or running or just walking and walking and walking until their legs got tired. Now, their favorite thing to do on the playground at recess was the slide. Who doesn't love the slide? But no matter how much she loved recess and playing with her friends, she always couldn't wait to go home. When the 3 o'clock bell rang that signaled the end of the day, Bella was ready to go home because she knew her best friend would be there waiting for her. Do you know who her best friend was, boys and girls? Yes, it was her dog. Her pet was always ready and waiting to greet her at the door when she walked home from school. Good old Rover. The end. So that was a draw and tell story, boys and girls. I hope you liked it. And if you want to find out more about draw and tell or learn how to do your own draw and tell story, you can go to YouTube or Pinterest with Mom and Dad's help, and you can see lots of demonstrations online. And then you can practice some on your own. Our next story is about a little baby duck who's ready to start school. It's called Off to School, Baby Duck by Amy Hest. Baby Duck could not eat her breakfast. It was the first day of school, and her stomach was all jitters. "Breakfast toast is very tasty," said Mrs. Duck. "Won't you have a bite?"
"No,"
Baby said.
"Breakfast juice is very juicy," said Mr. Duck. "Won't you have a sip?"
"No," Baby said.
"Your sister Hot Stuff is way too small to go to school," Mrs. Duck pointed out. She's not brave enough either. Aren't you glad to be big and brave?
No, Baby said.
Baby Duck sat under the table with her blue school bag. Baby loved her school bag and the important things inside. One favorite book, a sandwich with jam, one tall pad, and one yellow pencil, a special going to school present from Hot Stuff. Button up your new school sweater, called Mrs. Duck. Hurry, Baby! Baby buttoned. It took a long time.
Buckle up your new school shoes, called Mr. Duck. Hurry, Baby!
Baby buckled. It took a long time. Mr. Duck looked at his watch.
Time to go, he cried.
Mr. and Mrs. Duck bustled out the front door, swinging Hot Stuff in the air. Their feet crunched on dry leaves.
Come, come, they cried. School, glorious school!
Baby Duck dragged behind. Goodbye, house, she whispered in a little small voice. The Duck family waddled down the road.
Hop to it, Baby, called Mr. Duck.
Baby could not hop. Her feet felt too heavy.
Chin up, Baby, called Mrs. Duck. Skip along.
Baby could not skip. Her school bag was bumping. Bumpity, bumpity, bump. The Duck family waddled to the big schoolhouse. Baby's buckle popped open, and now her shoe was flapping. Flappity, flappity, flap.
Calling all babies, here I am.
Grandpa was waiting on a bench. Baby sat right up close to Grandpa.
Rough day, he whispered.
Yes, Baby said.
Long walk, whispered Grandpa.
Yes, Baby said.
Scared about school, whispered Grandpa.
Yes, Baby said. Yes, yes, yes.
So she's nervous about starting school, isn't she? I know she's going to love it once she gets inside, but Baby Duck's a little bit worried.
Sometimes it helps to sing a song, Grandpa said. You sing nice songs, Baby.
Yes, Baby said. I do.
And then Baby sang a song. Please don't make me go to school. My teacher will be mean. I won't have any fun or friends. And who will buckle my new shoe?
I will, Grandpa said. And he buckled Baby's shoe.
After that, Baby showed Grandpa the important things inside her school bag. He liked the pencil from Hot Stuff.
You draw nice pictures, Baby, Grandpa pointed out.
Yes, Baby said. I do.
And then Baby drew a picture. Davy Duck took little steps toward Baby. He looked at Baby's picture. Baby felt proud. Do you think Davy's admiring her picture? Yeah, he likes it, and that makes her feel good, doesn't it? Maybe Davy can be a new friend, her first new school friend. Miss Posey came across the schoolyard.
My name is Miss Posey, she said. I'm the teacher.
Are you mean? Grandpa asked.
Oh, no, said Miss Posey.
Do you sing songs in that schoolhouse? Grandpa asked.
Oh, yes, said Miss Posey.
Do you read books in there? Grandpa asked.
Oh, yes, said Miss Posey.
Do you like sandwiches with jam and yellow pencils? Grandpa asked.
Oh, yes, said Miss Posey.
Miss Posey rang the bell.
Good luck, Grandpa said, shaking Baby's hand.
Then Mr. and Mrs. Duck took turns kissing Baby on both cheeks.
We'll be right here, they promised, when school lets out.
Baby Hot Stuff cried, wah, wah, wah. Baby Duck put her arm around Hot Stuff.
Little small babies have to wait, she said.
She gave Hot Stuff the picture she had made.
Chin up, Baby said.
Then Baby Duck hopped and skipped into the big schoolhouse with her new friend, Davy Duck. She sang a pretty new song. Off to school, Baby Duck. I am big and brave. I like Miss Posy, Davy Duck too, and I'll have fun in school. And I bet you she did. Look, now she has a big smile across her face. She's ready for her first day. And I know you too are, boys and girls. You are ready for your first day of school. Some of you may be walking to school. Some of you might get dropped off by mom and dad. Lots of you will be riding a big school bus to get to school, won't you? And that reminds me of a song that you all know, and it's called The Wheels on the Bus. Let's sing it together, but you have to promise to be singing with me at home and doing the motions, okay? All right, here we go. The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round all through the town. The doors on the bus go open and shut, open and shut, open and shut. The doors on the bus go open and shut all through the town. The wipers on the bus go swish, 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 swish. The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish all through the town. And the horn on the bus goes beep, 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 beep. The horn on the bus goes beep, beep, beep all through the town. And the driver on the bus says, move on back, move on back, move on back. The driver on the bus says, move on back all through the town. And the people on the bus go up and down, up and down, up and down. The people on the bus go up and down all through the town. The mice on the bus go squeak, 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 squeak. The mice on the bus go squeak, squeak, squeak all through the town. Did we say mice? Who brings a mouse on the school bus? That's silly. But our next book is about a special little mouse. A mouse who has a beautiful name. She's called Chrysanthemum. And she's about to start her first day of school. Let's read about Chrysanthemum by Kevin Hankus. The day she was born was the happiest day in her parents' lives. She's perfect, said her mother. Absolutely, said her father. And she was. She was absolutely perfect. Her name must be everything that she is, said her mother. Her name must be absolutely perfect, said her father. And it was. Chrysanthemum. Her parents named her Chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum is a type of flower, boys and girls. Chrysanthemum grew and grew and grew. And when she was old enough to appreciate it, Chrysanthemum loved her name. She loved the way it sounded when her mother woke her up. She loved the way it sounded when her father called her for dinner. And she loved the way it sounded when she whispered it to herself in the bathroom mirror. Chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum loved the way her name looked when it was written with ink on an envelope. She loved the way it looked when it was written with icing on her birthday cake. And she loved the way it looked when she wrote it herself with her fat orange crayon. Chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum. Chrysanthemum thought her name was absolutely perfect. And then she started school. On the first day, Chrysanthemum wore her sunniest dress and her brightest smile. She ran all the way. Hooray, said Chrysanthemum. School! But when Mr. Chud took the roll call, everyone giggled upon hearing Chrysanthemum's name. They laughed at her special name. Here's the other kids in her class. Dawn, Eve, Lois, Al, Les, Kay, Max, Sue, Bill, Pat, Tom, Sam, Ken, Joe, Rita, Victoria, and then Chrysanthemum. She has the longest name for sure, doesn't she?
It's so long, said Joe.
It scarcely fits on your name tag, said Rita, pointing.
I'm named after my grandmother, said Victoria.
You're named after a flower.
Chrysanthemum wilted.
She did not think her name was absolutely perfect.
Now she thought it was absolutely dreadful.
The rest of the day was not much better. During nap time, Victoria raised her hand and informed Mrs. Chudd that Chrysanthemum's name was spelled with 13 letters.
That's exactly as many as half the letters there are in the alphabet, Victoria explained.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Victoria, said Mr. Chudd. Now, put your head down.
If I had a name like yours, I'd change it, Victoria said, as the students lined up to go home.
I wish I could, thought Chrysanthemum miserably.
Welcome home, said her mother.
Welcome home, said her father.
School is no place for me, said Chrysanthemum. My name is too long. It scarcely fits on my name tag, and I'm named after a flower.
Oh, pish, said her mother. Your name is beautiful.
And precious, and priceless, and fascinating, and winsome, said her father.
It's everything you are, said her mother.
Absolutely perfect, said her father.
Chrysanthemum felt much better after her favorite dinner, macaroni and cheese with ketchup, and an evening filled with hugs and kisses and parcheesi. That night, Chrysanthemum dreamed that her name was Jane. It was an extremely pleasant dream.
Do you think she should change her name? Should she feel bad about her name?
I don't think so either. I think it's beautiful.
The next morning, Chrysanthemum wore her most comfortable jumper. She walked to school as slowly as she could. She dragged her feet in the dirt. Chrysanthemum, 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 she wrote.
She even looks like a flower, said Victoria, as Chrysanthemum played on the playground.
Let's pick her, said Rita, pointing.
Ooh, let's smell her, said Joe.
Chrysanthemum wilted again.
She did not think her name was absolutely perfect. She thought it was absolutely dreadful.
The rest of the day was not much better. During nap time, Victoria raised her hand and said,
A chrysanthemum is a flower. It lives in a garden with worms and other dirty things.
Thank you for sharing that with us, said Mr. Chudd. Now, put your head down.
I just cannot believe your name, Victoria said as the students lined up to go home.
Neither can I, thought Chrysanthemum miserably.
Welcome home, said her mother.
Welcome home, said her father.
School is no place for me, said Chrysanthemum. They said I even look like a flower, and they pretended to pick me and smell me.
Oh, pish, said her mother.
They're just jealous.
And envious, and begrudging, and discontented, and jaundiced, said her father.
Who wouldn't be jealous of a name like yours, said her mother.
After all, it's absolutely perfect, said her father.
Chrysanthemum felt a trifle better after her favorite dessert, chocolate cake with buttercream frosting, and another evening filled with hugs and kisses and parcheesi. That night, Chrysanthemum dreamed that she really was a chrysanthemum. She sprouted leaves and petals. Victoria picked her and plucked her, one by one, until there was nothing left but a scrawny stem. It was the worst nightmare of Chrysanthemum's life. Chrysanthemum wore her outfit with 7 pockets the next morning. She loaded the pockets with her most prized possessions and her good luck charms. Chrysanthemum took the longest route possible to school. She stopped and stared at each and every flower. Chrysanthemum, 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 the flowers seemed to say. That morning, the students were introduced to Mrs. Twinkle, the music teacher. Her voice was like something out of a dream, as was everything else about her. The students were speechless. They thought Mrs. Twinkle was an indescribable wonder. They went out of their way to make a nice impression. Mrs. Twinkle led the students in scales, and then she assigned roles for the class musical. Victoria was chosen as the dainty fairy queen. Rita was chosen as the spiffy butterfly princess. Joe was chosen as the all-important pixie messenger. And Chrysanthemum was chosen as a daisy. Chrysanthemum's a daisy! Chrysanthemum's a daisy! Joe, Rita, and Victoria chanted, thinking it was wildly funny. Chrysanthemum wilted. She did not think her name was absolutely perfect. She thought it was absolutely dreadful. "What's so humorous?" asked Mrs. Twinkle. "Chrysanthemum," was the answer. "Her name is so long," said Joe. "It scarcely fits on her name tag," said Rita, pointing. "I'm named after my grandmother," said Victoria. "She's named after a flower."
"My name is long," said Mrs. Twinkle.
"It is?" said Joe.
"My name would scarcely fit on a name tag," said Mrs. Twinkle.
"It would?" said Rita, pointing.
"And," said Mrs. Twinkle, "I'm named after a flower, too."
"You are?" said Victoria.
"Yes," said Mrs. Twinkle. "My name is Delphinium. Delphinium Twinkle. And if my baby is a girl, I'm considering Chrysanthemum as a name. I think it's absolutely perfect."
Chrysanthemum could scarcely believe her ears. She blushed, she beamed, she bloomed. Chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum, chrysanthemum.
"I think she's happy with her name again. She's proud of it."
"I would be too." Joe, Rita, and Victoria looked at Chrysanthemum longingly.
"Call me Marigold," said Joe.
"I'm Carnation," said Rita, pointing.
"My name is Lily of the Valley," said Victoria.
Chrysanthemum did not think her name was absolutely perfect. She knew it. And she is skipping home from school on that day, happy as can be. Do you see the smile on her face? Do you notice she's happy again? Yes, and she likes her name. Just like you all have a very special name. And when you go to school, you'll meet lots of new friends that all have different names. But you're also very special. Boys and girls, we're going to do another bus song. And this bus song happens to be by Tom Chapin. Enjoy and listen.
Here it comes round the corner, big and yellow and loud. Can't you hear it? The school bus coming to pick up the school bus crowd. It's very quiet on 4th Street. Kids are all up in bed. Then Mama bangs on the bedroom door, and this is what Mama said.
Get up, get up, get up, get up.
She makes an awful fuss.
Get up, get up, get up, get up. Don't miss the bus.
Make a right down to Main Street, round the circle and back. Can't you hear it? The school bus coming over the railroad track. Sleepy heads on 4th Street are tumbling out of the floor. Wash your face, brush your teeth. Oh no, there's a line at the bathroom door.
Get up, get up, get up, get up.
You're making me nervous.
Get up, get up, get up, get up. Don't miss the bus.
Betty Baker drives the bus. Betty Baker's neat. But Betty waits for no one, so you better move your feet.
on 4th Street. This is no time to play. Grab your backpack and drink your juice, cause the bus is a block away.
Have you seen my viola?
Don't forget your homework.
Oh no! How do you lose a viola?
Come on, it's time to go. Betty turns on 4th Street. Mama's getting upset. The bus comes screeching to a stop. Kids, aren't you ready yet? Hurrying, scurrying down the stairs. The bus door's opening wide. With a
hello, Betty.
Goodbye, Mom.
They disappear inside. Get up, get up, get up, get up.
Hey, Betty, wait for us.
Get up, get up, get up, get up. Don't miss the bus. You can miss your mama, miss your daddy, miss your Uncle Gus. You miss me and I'll miss you, but don't miss the bus. You can miss some sleep, mystify and miscellaneous. You can misbehave and misconstrue, but don't miss the bus. Don't miss the bus. Mama will be furious.
Well, I can't believe it, boys and girls, but we are almost out of time on today's Book Nook show. But don't forget where you can go for lots more books about school or books on any topic. Where do you come? The library, that's right. And I just want to mention some more of my favorites that are perfect to read right before going back to school. The Kissing Hand by Audrey Penn. First Grade, Here I Come by Nancy Carlson. And Oh, My Baby Little One by Kathy A. Pelt. And there's lots more. Here's a funny one about superhero school. So lots more, and you know where you can come to check them out. I look very forward to seeing you here at the library. And again, I wish you the best of luck on the start of a brand new school year. Bye-bye.